Mr. Ngatia, there has been this issue of extrajudicial killings in Kenya that have always gone unpunished. These killings continue in our country. What is the view of KRA?
First and foremost, I would like to congratulate Mr. Luis Moreno Ocampo, the prosecutor in Hague, simply because he added to the Uhuru Muthaura Ali charges, because if you remember very well, we have been fighting for extrajudicial killings to stop. We have done several videos about the killing of Kenyan youth, regardless which tribes they belong. In fact, we would like Mr. Ocampo to pursue these charges of impunity, because the Kenyan government, under the police, killing schools, for instance, Kwekwe Squad, Frying Squad, Rhino Squad, ETC, have been formed to eliminate Mogiki, especially Mogiki, or politically connected youth. For instance, the killing of Mr. Kangara and the Oulu of human rights defenders in Kenya. Their killing happened when Professor Alston was in Kenya investigating the human rights violation. And to this day, nobody has been taken to court for their killing. They were killed at the daylight, in daylight. Their cars was pumped with bullets, and the killers went scot-free to this day. So we want Mr. Ocampo to pursue the killings of Mogiki youth, because Uhuru has killed so many Mogikis, especially those he used in killing people in Rift Valley, Nakuru, and Nairobi. Remember, the leader of Mogiki, Jenga's wife and his driver, was also killed. And to this day, nobody has stood on a trial. These people, the killing squad in Kenya, under the police or under the state house, has killed the KAR boss, Bernard Kimeli, Joseph Cheptalus, who was investigating the theft of gold from Zaire, Gatimba Karanja, former police CID boss, who was poisoned and died in his house after leaving for a meeting that was called at the police headquarters. Nyasenda, the former police boss, whose immediate death surprised anybody. To this day, the man was killed. We demand investigation. In fact, we really demand, we seriously demand the killers of these people should be arrested, because they are not anonymous, they are known. They are squads within the police force, specialized, trained in killing people, people authorized to kill, and nobody can attack them or punish them. They are above the law, they are protected. These are ruling class killing squads, or assassination execution platoons.
Now, if these people cannot be brought to book, what will happen to impunity in Kenya?
It will continue. And unless revolution takes over the way we have seen in North Africa and in Libya, nothing else will stop this impunity in Kenya that has been perpetrated for the last 50 years. Some time is coming. And the time is right for Kenyan people to say enough is enough.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ngatia.